Dying, Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ. Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory, as in baptism Robert Weidler put on Christ. So in Christ, may Robert Weidler be clothed with glory. Here and now, dear friends, we are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. Friends, we have gathered here to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Robert Weidler. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace, that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow, hope, in death, resurrection. Will you please pray with me? Eternal God, we praise you for the great company of all those who have finished their course in faith and now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us whom we name in our hearts before you. Especially we praise you for Robert Weidler, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, grant your peace. Let perpetual light shine upon them and help us so to believe where we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through our years and bring us at last into them, with them, into the joy of your home. Not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 1 through 8. Comfort for God's people. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem. and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice of one calling, in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are like grass, and all their faithfulness is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers, and the flowers fall. Because the breath of the Lord blows on them, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, and the flowers fall. But the word of our God endures forever. Our psalm reading is from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And the gospel reading comes from John chapter 14, verses 1 through 7. Jesus comforts his disciples. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. May God bless the hearing and the reading of the word, and may we come to understand it as it relates to our lives and Robert's life. Born on July 31st, 1935, a son of Fred and Martha Hauser Weidler, Jr. He was raised and educated south of Elba, where he attended grade school in the Cooley School District in Brown Township. He graduated from Velva High School in 1953. Following graduation, Bob worked as a farm laborer for Henry Franson. In 1958, Bob enlisted into the United States Army. He proudly served his country until his honorable discharge in 1960. He resumed farming with the Franson family until he and Christy Knutson took over the operation. Then they were later joined in farming with Elton, Ray, Harold, and Alan. Bob retired in 2018. Bob enjoyed being out in the shop, going for rides around the countryside, and getting together with family. Bob was a wonderful uncle that will be greatly missed. Robert is survived by his nephews, Alan Weidler, Dean and Melanie Weidler, David and Susan Weidler, all of Velva, North Dakota, niece Jane Weidler and Todd Joson of South Sioux City, Nebraska, great nieces and nephews, Lindsay and Marshall Knopf, Brendan and Beth Weidler, Jordan and Carly Weidler, Hannah Weidler, Matthew and Amanda Weidler, Tommy and Leah Weidler, Josh and Corey Weidler, and Sarah and Tyler Histas. Great, great nieces and nephews, Blakely, Kirby, Quinn, Hayes, Patty, Lou, Harrison, Keela, Peyton, Coulter, Hudson, Ava, Callie, Augustus, Collins, Kaysen, and Evelyn. He was preceded in death by his parents, brother, Harold, and sister-in-law, Lois Ann. We gather here this morning in memory of our brother in Christ, Robert Weidler. We gather here to grieve and mourn our loss. We gather to remember and reflect upon his life, a life in which each of you were blessed to share. We gather here to comfort and console one another, but we also gather to celebrate the love of God in whom there is no death. We gather here with teary eyes and saddened hearts. Loss and grief and sadness have overcome our emotions. The sting of death is an all too present of a reality in our lives this day. But into the pain of Robert's death, into your emptiness and sadness and grief, bursts the eternal promise of God, proclaiming victory over death and the promise of life everlasting. For by our Lord's death on the cross, death becomes for Robert and for all the faithful simply a doorway to eternal life with Jesus. God has blessed each and every one of us with a very precious gift. And this gift has been entrusted into our care. It's a gift that can be given by no one other than God. And God bestows this gift very generously. without request, without restrictions. It is the gift of life itself. And God has generously bestowed this gift upon Robert Weidler. Unfortunately, it oftentimes is only when this gift is taken away or threatened with illness or injury that we pause to consider or marvel at this gift. And although we go to great lengths to avoid admitting it, we all know that someday we all will die. Yet this is not the end for the faithful. Death for the faithful is a life brought to completion and perfection in Jesus. Robert is now experiencing the fullness of his life in the presence of Jesus, life as God intended it to be lived, in his glory forever and ever. Our gospel lesson has its setting in the upper room where the disciples have eaten the Passover meal. And Jesus knew exactly what the next few hours and days were going to bring. So he prepared his disciples to face the future without fear. The words, "Do not let your hearts be troubled," were addressed by Jesus to all the disciples, but we can rightly include ourselves in his audience and apply them to our own hearts and our own lives. As Christians, we're exposed to many adversities, troubles, and even sorrow and suffering, sometimes on a daily basis. What this passage teaches us is that while we cannot prevent the many adversities and losses of life, we are able to find the strength and the power with the help of the Lord to get through them. One of the most amazing things that Jesus reveals to us is found in verse 2. "In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you." This is one of the greatest truths found anywhere in the Bible. And it implies that God dwells somewhere in a permanent place. The word rooms is actually translated mansions. And the Greek says, "In the house of the Father of me abodes many there are." What Jesus is teaching us is that in God's house, which is heaven, there are many mansions to live. And to me, that gives me a lot of great comfort that I can know for sure that Jesus has already prepared a mansion in heaven for Robert. My Father's house is where I'm always accepted and always loved. My Father's house is where I'm not a guest, but where I'm a resident. And that's home. The second great truth we learn from this passage is that Jesus will come back. Stop and think about that for a moment. Jesus isn't just going to show us the way or write out some instructions for us about how we can get to heaven. but he's going to come back and take us by the hand and personally lead us to our Father's house. Another great truth from this passage in John chapter 14 is that we will be with the Lord forever. To me, that must be what makes heaven so wonderful. When our lives are focused upon Christ, we walk in glory with Him forever. This passage of Scripture in the Gospel of John is the greatest promise of hope that Jesus ever made. When our lives are focused upon Jesus, we walk hand in hand with Him in victory. For Jesus takes care of your past, He helps you with your present, and He's already prepared for your future. But the sure and confident promise of God is that we will be reunited with those who have gone before us in faith. And so we gather today in faith, in joyful thanksgiving to God for the life of Robert, our brother in Christ. And by faith, even in the midst of our own personal and profound sadness, we can celebrate with him that final victory that he has now won over death through Jesus Christ. May you find comfort and peace and hope in the Lord Jesus Christ, in whom there is light and life eternal. Amen. Will you please pray with me? God of us all, your love never ends. When all else fails, you still are God. We pray to you for one another in our need, and for all anywhere who celebrate Robert's life with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. To all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. O God, all that you have given us is yours. As first you gave Robert to us, now we give Robert back to you. Receive Robert into the arms of your mercy. Raise Robert up with all your people. Receive us also, and raise us into a new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. God of love, we thank you for all with which you have blessed us, even to this day, for the gift of joy in days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise in days of pain and grief. We praise you for home and friends and for our baptism and place in your church with all who have faithfully lived and died. Above all else, we thank you for Jesus, who knew our griefs, who died our death, and rose for our sake, and who lives and prays for us. And as he taught us, so now we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. God who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies. Also through the Spirit that dwells in you. Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body also dwells secure. Lord, show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Will you pray with me? O God, you have ordered this wonderful world and know all things in earth and in heaven. Give us such faith that by day and by night, at all times and in all places, we may without fear commit ourselves and those dear to us to your never-failing love in this life and in the life to come. Amen. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and to an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you. In this you rejoice, though now for a little while you suffer trials, so that the genuineness of your faith may prove itself worthy at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Without having seen him, yet you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe. You believe in him and rejoice with unutterable and exalted joy. As the harvest of your faith, you reap the salvation of your souls. Almighty God, into your hands we commend your son, Robert Weidler, in sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. This body we commit to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. Will you please pray with me? Eternal God, you have shared with us the life of Robert Weidler. Before he was ours, he is yours. For all that Robert has given us to make us what we are, for that of him which lives and grows in each of us, and for his life that it in your love will never end, we give you thanks. As now we offer Robert back into your arms, comfort us in our loneliness, strengthen us in our weakness, and give us courage to face the future unafraid. Draw those of us who remain in this life closer to one another. Make us faithful to serve one another, and give us to know that peace and joy which is eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now to the one who is able to keep you from falling and to make you stand without blemish in the presence of God's glory with rejoicing, to the only God our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen.
Sign from above,
sign from above,
on the wings of a dove,
on the wings of a dove.
When troubles surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. When these things be said, does not forget us. He sends down his blood on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love. A sign from above,
sign from above,
on the wings of a dove. Blood many days he searched for land in various ways. Troubles he had some, but wasn't forgotten. He sent him his love on the wings of a dove. Of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love. A sign from above,
sign from above,
on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love. A sign from above.